Toronto is the capital city of the province of Ontario in Canada. It is located in the southeastern part of the province on the northwestern shore of Lake Ontario. Toronto is the most populous city in Canada and the provincial capital of Ontario. It is a diverse and multicultural city, known for its landmarks. Toronto is also known for its world-renowned festivals, theater and music scene, and vibrant nightlife. It is a major center for finance, technology, and culture in Canada, and is home to many major corporations and businesses. Toronto is also home to several major universities and colleges, including the University of Toronto, York University, and Ryerson University, making it a popular destination for students and educators. Let's have a look at best places to visit in Toronto. Number 1. Nathan Phillips Square. Nathan Phillips Square is a public square in Toronto. It is located in front of Toronto City Hall and is named after Nathan Phillips, the mayor of Toronto from 1955 to 1962. The square is a popular gathering place for residents and visitors and is home to many events and festivals throughout the year. The square features a large reflecting pool, which serves as the centerpiece of the space and is surrounded by gardens and lawns. The square also features several sculptures and works of public art, including the Peace Garden, which features a large bronze sculpture of a dove. The square is also home to the iconic Toronto sign, a large illuminated sign displaying the city name. The sign has become a popular photo opportunity for visitors and locals alike. Number 2. Eaton Centre. The Eaton Centre is a large shopping mall in downtown Toronto. It is located on Yonge Street, between Queen Street and Dundas Street, and is one of the most popular tourist destinations in the city. The mall is named after the Eaton's department store chain, which was once a major presence in Canadian retail but has since been dissolved. The Eaton Centre features over 250 stores, including major department stores, fashion retailers, and specialty shops. The mall is known for its architecture and design, including a large glass galleria that runs the length of the building and provides natural light to the interior. The Eaton Centre also features several public art installations, including the Toronto sign, which is located in the mall's urban park and is a popular photo opportunity. Number 3. Toronto Islands. The Toronto Islands are a chain of small islands located in Lake Ontario, just off the shore of Toronto. The islands are a popular recreational destination and are accessible by ferry from the mainland. They are home to several beaches, parks, and attractions, such as the Centreville Amusement Park and the Toronto Island Marina. The island also includes a small residential community and the Billy Bishop Toronto City Airport. The Toronto Islands were created by sediment deposited by glaciers, and they were originally connected to the mainland, but were separated due to the natural process of erosion. The Toronto Islands are a diverse and unique ecosystem, with a variety of habitats including wetlands, woodlands, and meadows. Number 4. Casa Loma. Casa Loma is a historic house and gardens. It was built between 1911 and 1914 as a residence for financier Sir Henry Mill Pellat, who was one of Canada's wealthiest men at the time. The house is an example of the Gothic Revival architectural style and features 98 rooms, including secret passages, towers, and a large conservatory. The house also features a collection of artwork and antiques, as well as a 5-acre garden that includes a rock garden, a flower garden, and a lake. Casa Loma was a private residence for only a few years before financial difficulties forced Sir Henry to abandon the house in 1923. The City of Toronto acquired the property in 1933, and it was opened to the public as a museum in 1937. Number 5. Niagara Falls. Niagara Falls is a group of three waterfalls located on the Niagara River on the border of Ontario, Canada, and New York, USA. While the falls are located on the border between the two countries, the Canadian side of Niagara Falls is considered to be the best place to view the falls. The Canadian side offers a wider and more panoramic view of the falls, as well as several observation decks and lookout points. The falls can be viewed from the top of the Skyline Tower or from the Maid of the Mist boat tour, which takes visitors to the base of the falls. Toronto is located about 130 kilometers from the Niagara Falls. It can be reached by car, bus, or train. It is a popular day trip destination for residents of Toronto and visitors to the city. Number 6. Dundas Square. Yonge Dundas Square, commonly referred to as Dundas Square, is a public square. It is located at the intersection of Yonge Street and Dundas Street and is considered to be the Times Square of Toronto. The square is a popular gathering place for locals and visitors alike and is known for its large digital billboards, public art installations, and events. The square is surrounded by several shopping centers, restaurants, and entertainment venues, and is a popular spot for street performers and vendors. It also features several public seating areas and a large stage that is used for concerts, festivals, and other events. The square is also home to several sculptures and public art installations, including the Eyes on Toronto sculpture, which is a pair of large eyes that look out over the square. Number 7. Ripley's Aquarium. Ripley's Aquarium of Canada is a public aquarium. It is one of the largest aquariums in the country and is home to over 16,000 aquatic animals from over 450 species. The aquarium features several galleries and exhibits, including the Canadian Waters Gallery, which showcases the diverse aquatic life found in Canadian waters, and the Dangerous Lagoon, which is a walk-through tunnel exhibit featuring sharks, rays, and other large fish. Ripley's Aquarium is also home to several interactive exhibits, such as the Ray Bay, where visitors can touch and feed the rays, and the Discovery Center, where visitors can learn about the different species of aquatic animals and their habitats. Number 8. CN Tower. The CN Tower is a 553-meter-high concrete communications and observation tower. It was completed in 1976 and was the tallest freestanding structure in the world until 2010. The CN Tower is a major tourist attraction and is visited by over 2 million people annually. The CN Tower has several observation decks, including the lookout level at 346 meters and the skypod level at 447 meters. These levels offer spectacular views of the city and the surrounding area. The CN Tower also features a glass floor observation deck at 342 meters that allows visitors to look straight down at the city below. Number 9. The Royal Ontario Museum. The Royal Ontario Museum is a museum of world culture and natural history. It is one of the largest museums in North America and the most visited museum in Canada. The Royal Ontario Museum has a diverse collection of over 6 million artifacts and specimens, spanning from ancient civilizations to modern times. The museum features several permanent galleries, including the World Culture Galleries, which showcase the art and artifacts of ancient and modern civilizations from around the world, and the Natural History Galleries, which feature fossils, minerals, and other natural specimens. The Royal Ontario Museum also has several special exhibitions that change periodically, showcasing art, culture, and science from around the world. Number 10. The Rogers Centre. The Rogers Centre, formerly known as the Sky Dome, is a multi-purpose stadium. It is home to the Toronto Blue Jays of Major League Baseball and the Toronto Argonauts of the Canadian Football League. The stadium was opened in 1989 and is known for its unique retractable roof, which allows for both indoor and outdoor events to be held at the venue. The Rogers Centre also hosts concerts and other special events. The stadium has a seating capacity of around 50,000 for baseball games and around 55,000 for football games. It has a variety of amenities, such as luxury suites, a restaurant, and a hotel. The Rogers Centre is considered one of the most technologically advanced stadiums in the world, with features like a fully retractable roof, a hotel, and a hard surface field that can be converted between baseball and football configurations.